Dear students, you have now learned the topic Nadanpe. Now we are going to revise it. So you have learned about the Nadanpe. The Nadanpe is called as the Heart of India. What it is called? It is called Heart of India because Nadanpe is highly fertile. So what does the word fertile means? The fertile means the capacity or ability of the soil to grow good crops is called as the fertile. So here, if this Nadan plains are highly fertile and it lies between Himalayan mountain and Deccan plateau. So where does your Nadan plain lies? It lies between Himalayan mountains and Deccan plateau. Now these Himalayan plain is divided into three. The first one is the Punjab plain, the second one is the Ganga plain, and the third one is the Brahmaputra plain. So your Nadan plain is divided into three. The first one is the Punjab plain, the Ganga plain, and the Brahmaputra plain. Now we are going to talk about the Punjab plain. So Punjab plain, here the rivers are mainly Indus and their tributaries. Tributaries means they flow from the Indus River, that is they divide when they move further. So this Punjab plain is the western part of the Nadan plain. And here it is formed by the deposition of new alluvium soil, and this soil is again highly fertile, and with this deposition of alluvium soil near the river bank, it is called as bed. What it is called? It is called as bed. The soil here, the soil of the Punjab plain, is the extremely fertile soil. I have explained what is the meaning of fertile soil. So here the soil is extremely fertile, and here the major crop grown in Punjab is your rice, wheat, maize, sugar cane, and due to this reason your Punjab plain are also called as the bread basket of India. Now the second one is your Ganga plain. Coming on to the Ganga plain, here the rivers are Ganga, Yamuna, Ghagra, Gandak, Kosi and Teshti. Now these land are also very fertile, and here there is a flourishing trade and industries. Now this is the most populous place or most populous plain of India. The reason is, firstly, here the soil is fertile, and secondly, here is an extremely flourish trade and industries which provide employment in this plain. Now the Ganga Brahmaputra is the world's largest delta river. Now we are coming to the Brahmaputra plain. The Brahmaputra plain, the main river is the Brahmaputra. When it moves to the Arunachal Pradesh, here the name changes, the river name changes from Brahmaputra to Shyam. Now again, this plain is rich in minerals like natural gas, petroleum, limestone and coal. Now here we are going to study that Majuli Island is the largest island in the Brahmaputra plain. So now we have discussed about the three plains, that is your Punjab plain, Ganga plain and the Brahmaputra plain. We have also studied about the plain, what are the main rivers which flows in this plain, and now we are going to discuss about the importance of this plain. So what is the importance of this plain? When we are reading about the importance, as the soil is fertile, this would be rich in agriculture. Now, as the soil is fertile, what happened here? This plain is rich in agriculture, that means it is good for growing the crops. The second one is, as there is good agriculture here, there are various mills. Okay, so that is your, it may be your sugar cane mill, then your rice mills, you are having textiles. So due to a rich agriculture here, the mills are also formed here which provide the employment there. Now you are having sports article here, you are getting good sports article. So here is your sports article. Then you are having here iron, steel and jute mill. Iron, steel and jute mills. Now, the next one is we are going to learn about the hydroelectric power plant. So, what are these hydroelectric power plant? Hydroelectric power plant are the plants which produces electricity by constructing the big dams. Now, in hydroelectric power plant, there are various power plant in the Northern Plain. That is your Tehri power plant, Bhakra, Nangal, and Dehar dams. And due to this dam, there is the construction of the hydroelectric power plant. Then, lastly, we are discussing about the biodiversity. There is a good biodiversity in Northern Plain, that means a variety of flora and fauna is present here, which make it famous for the wildlife here. So students, I am reminding you again the importance. The first one is the rich agriculture. The second one is many kinds of mills are present here, like your sugar mill, rice mill, textile mills. You are getting wood sports article, you are getting iron, steel and jute mills also. And there is a hydroelectric power plant, that means electricity is generated with the help of dams and you are getting a good biodiversity here. I hope you might have understood the chapter.